A comprehensive study documenting the population dynamics of one of the premier mule deer herds in the U.S. is entering its sixth year of study, giving biologists a better understanding of how these deer interact with their habitat, their migration patterns, and their ability to survive in the landscape. The Wyoming Range Project has tracked these deer using their migration corridors, documented fawn survival rates of the herd, along with habitat and nutritional factors, and the general ecology parameters of the population. Wyoming Game and Fish Department biologist Gary Fralick in the Jackson region says Wyoming Range deer are gradually rebounding from a brutal winter in 2016-17 that virtually claimed the entire fawn crop from that year.
With the severe winter of 2016-2017 past now, we've noticed that open winters and the ability of mule deer to access all of the winter range, not just the core area, allows those animals to ultimately come off the winter ranges in a little bit better shape than they did in March and April of 2017. So habitat is really the primary focus of our research, and that is, of course, reflective in the body condition of these mule deer. So in the end, we want to better understand how mule deer reflect through their body condition, the conditions that they experience on their summer range, fall range, and then ultimately full circle to winter and spring.
Fralick says good moisture this past spring on summer ranges resulted in good forage production and enabled the deer to put on some extra pounds, so to speak, in the form of body fat that gives these deer a better chance to survive the tough winters western Wyoming is known for. It also gave biologists the opportunity to place more collars on fawns. Over 80 were collared in June and July to allow researchers to follow them to the winter ranges near LaBarge, Evanston, and Cokeville. A new component for 2019 involves collaring mule deer bucks to gather similar data, but also how they respond to the environment in a migratory behavior, along with how they respond to hunting pressure, habitat changes, and whether migration patterns differ from that of does. That study is now just underway. This is Ray Hageman with the Wyoming Game and Fish Department.